Avidya and Pradnya were having a talk about seeing God.
I want to see God. Where is He? Why can't I see Him?
Avidya, our senses are imperfect. An eagle in the flight can repeatedly sight a rabbit 2 miles away, which any human being cannot. A human being cannot even see without sunlight.
Yes, you are right. We cannot see objects which are very far off or very near, or very small like microscopic organisms.
Yes, Avidya, and there are other hindrances which can block our vision, like cataract, fog, or even a wall. Other senses like our ears are also limited with a limited hearing capacity between 20 Hz to 20,000 Hz. We cannot see our mind, emotions, thoughts, ambitions, or intelligence. These are abstract in nature. So, how can we see God, Avidya?
God's body is not made of 5 elements like ours, namely earth, water, fire, air, and ether. It is completely spiritual. Our body is made of these ingredients. So, with these material eyes, we cannot see the Supreme Lord.
Avidya prays to God as follows.
O God, come and stand before me. Give me money, car, and bungalow. Pass me in my exams. Whenever I want, I should be able to see you.
God is no one's servant. We have to oblige Him by our love and service. We all know how difficult it is to see the king or a president of a country. Take for example, if someone wants to meet the Prime Minister of India, Mr. Modi, one has to take many appointments and still there is no guarantee of meeting him. Krishna has created millions of such Modis. Just imagine how hard it could be to meet him. It is practically impossible for an ordinary man to get an interview with such an important person, to say nothing of having this important person to come and stand before him. Yet people are demanding that the Supreme Personality of Godhead come and stand before him.
Oh, then how can I see him?
Okay, let's take again the example of Mr. Modi. If you know someone who is close to him, then you can easily meet him. Similarly, if you can please Krishna's dear associates, then they will enable you to see him. According to the Brahma Samhita, I worship Govinda, the Supreme Primeval Lord, who is Shyam Sundara, Krishna himself with inconceivable, innumerable attributes, whom the pure devotees see in the heart of hearts with the eye of devotion, tinged with the ointment of love.
Oh, so do you mean to say that Krishna, his name, fame, qualities, and paraphernalia cannot be materially understood unless one is advanced in spiritual life?
Yes, you're correct. One cannot see Krishna generally, but the ability to see Krishna also depends on Krishna's mercy. You need the ointment of love to see Krishna and also the association of advanced devotees.